Hey guys, Tom here and welcome back to another ROM review. In this video, I'm going to review AOKP ROM for Micromax Yureka. I do upload videos once or twice every week and most of my videos are ROM reviews. So in case you don't want to miss any of my future videos, please click that subscribe button and it will also support my work. So AOKP means Android Open Caching Project. AOKP for this device is developed by developer called Preet Patel CM, and huge thanks to the developer for making this ROM real, and we users respect your work. And without any further ado, I'll show you how to install this ROM. First, you need a router, custom recovery ready Yureka, and you need to go to recovery by holding down power button and volume up and down simultaneously after powering off your device. After Android recovery, I highly recommend to take an Android backup of your current system, so in case something goes wrong, you can revert back to your previous state. After taking an Android backup, you need to wipe your current system. So for that, click Wipe, Advanced Wipe, select Dalvik Cache, System, Data and Cache, and swipe the Wipe button. It will take a while. After that, go back and install and find the ROM from your storage. Install the ROM and don't forget to install gapps for this ROM. After installing both ROM and gapps, reboot the device. So the ROM boots up in 5 minutes and 42 seconds. So this ROM is based on Android 7.1.1 Nougat and the build date is 10th February, so things may change by the time you watch this. The developer states that it is the best SOT ROM for Micromax Yureka in the thread title, and it does what it says. By using this ROM for a while, I found that it got no heating issues and gives very fluid experience with a great battery life. The developer strongly recommend to keep the current kernel of this ROM because the kernel is configured to provide a better experience with a better battery life. Fix for data toggle issue in Nougat ROMs is inbuilt in this ROM, so good job from the developer in that, and this ROM is vault ready. Even if this ROM is configured to increase the battery life, the performance of this ROM is really good. The transitions are really fluid and I didn't find any lags while using this ROM. So really good job from the developer for making this ROM. And in terms of feature, it contains almost all Resurrection Remix features. So thumbs up for feature section. And CM Audio FX is inbuilt in this ROM, which is absent in some Nougat ROMs. And the extra features I found in this ROM is the 3 or 4 new gestures compared to common CM gestures. And another one is the we can swipe the quick setting preview in notification panel just like all Samsung Touch Screens, which is kind of cool feature. And in terms of bugs, the one and only bug I found in this ROM is the backlight problem. Hardware keys are perfectly fine, but the backlight is not working. The developer states that it can be fixed by changing some codes in the build.prof file. If you want to know more details about that, go to the forum post of Preet Patel. For that, click the first link in the description. And I use software buttons, so it's not a big deal for me. And everything else is really, really good. I highly recommend to use this ROM. It is really good as Resurrection Remix. And that's it for this video. And if you got any questions or something else to ask, use the comment section. I'll definitely respond to every single comment. And if you found this video useful, please click that like button. It means a lot to me. And that's it. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next one.